Hello everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Minecraft here on the Grishno Realm. This is a brand new realm, so I'm really excited to show you some of what's been going on today. If you look over here... So we have a couple projects today. We're going to do a couple things on the server. We're going to see how it turns out. And I'm gonna try editing this in a different way, so we'll see how it comes together. If you like it, you know, you can hit the like button, you can let me know. If you don't, you know, just hit the dislike button or something like that. I don't know, just leave a comment. Tell me your editing's total shit or something. Like, tell me, and I will be happy to listen. But today we're gonna be playing a little bit of Minecraft here on the Grishno Realm, and I'm really excited to show you. I'm really excited to show you what's been going on. So, first things first today is we have a lot of farming to catch up on. There we go, now we have some stacks of pumpkins and potatoes and seeds, which is really exciting. We also have some wheat. So we're just gonna go ahead and deposit this here at the mega farm. I haven't shown you this, but essentially you can put in anything that you harvest there. It's eventually gonna work its way up to the control room. So you can see there's everything that we did. It's gonna sort itself up there. We do have a bunch of automatic farms in here. So we have some auto sugarcane, auto pumpkins, auto cactus, and then sort of the mother lode, the big granddaddy. We have our five-story farm. So we'll flip the switch. Everything washes down. Gets sucked up, goes through some pipes underneath, and gets shot up the elevator. It'll take you right up here to the control room where it's automatically being sorted into different chests and being processed into different things like dyes and paper and things like that. So pretty exciting. We do have a poisonous potato, so we'll just toss that out of our inventory. We'll turn off the water and we will replant the farm. And it looks like we're all planted up. This is just gonna finish up. Check the hopper. Looks like we need to transfer some seeds. Go, three stacks of seeds up to the double chest because we have so many seeds. There we go. That's the super farm. The other thing that's right here next to the base. This is my base, by the way. This is my home. It's very exciting. It's in Baytown. You can see it. Here's our water cooler right here, but it says right up there, Baytown. Bees are really hard to make with banners. Let's see how we're doing here. Oh no! Oh no! No! You son of a bitch! You son of a bitch! Oh, fuck me. I had two villagers here. Oh, man. Man, I'm gonna have to get some villagers. Alright, so we have a project today. We have some things to do. This is our looting sword. Come here, friend. Come here. I am right here. Alright, we'll just shoot you. You're just gonna get shot. There you go. We'll flush this. So this is our mob farm that we're using to get basically gunpowder, but also bones. We're getting some rotten flesh. Skeletons are also dropping here. Spiders, witches. So we're getting a lot of different drops from this thing. It's pretty good when you're the only person on the server, especially if you're over in the area. But of course that means that we had to make a nice little waiting area. Oh, I'm so bummed. I'm so bummed. I'm so bummed about that. So this is the creeper, bar and grill. You can see we have a pool game right here. try and... Oh, too much. There we go. There we go. Oh, I just missed. Just missed. You get 3 arrows. You try and get it in the pockets, you get 1 point per arrow in the pocket. We also have a darts game, so if you want to take a look, see if you can get all 6 targets. You want to get as close to the center as you can. That was a bad shot. That was a bad shot. Totally missed the center. Got it there. Got it there. Got it there. Got it there. Kind of guy there, like on the edge. On the edge, just a little bit. So that starts, and that's pool. It's where the bar and grill. We used to have 2 villagers, which I guess we're gonna be getting back. What a pain! What a pain in the butt. Oh my gosh. All right, so we're gonna do some villager moving, maybe today. Before we get to any of that today, I wanted to show off my house and a little bit of the village and the server and sort of just show you around what you can expect when you come onto the Grishno Minecraft realm. So the first thing that you're going to notice right here at the house is the base. Really excited about the base. It's coming along. It's a work in progress. You can see we have a lot of cobble still. We have some floors that aren't in, but it's coming together. Quartz is really, really expensive. It's a big pain in the butt to collect. I'm building all the floors out of quartz. I'm also doing a lot of stained glass. But I think it's coming along. It's coming along. You can see just up there is Annette's house. Our neighbor lives right up there, which is pretty exciting. I also need to get some flooring in. The house is not done. The house is not done. We have a storage system. I'm going to grab the elytra really quick. We have a horse, we have a llama in there, our little llama, and this eventually is going to be like a pool, maybe a natural area, I'm not sure. Still working out what's going to be happening down here. If you go down here, you can sort of get into the subway. This connects you to the rest of town. There's also the map room. You can see this is what we're looking at on the server. So our house is right here. You can see what I just showed you. There's Annette's house. There's the water tower, BTs on top of it. There's the mega farm, the little park. Out here we have some really interesting stuff. Kitten's gone over here and really just terraformed the fuck out of this swamp, and it's incredible. It's incredible. You have to go over there. You have to see it. It's so much fun. Maybe we'll fly over today and see what it looks like. And then there's also some areas over here that have been worked on. It's the spawning zone. So when you join the server, you'll come in right there, and there's a couple different things. There's also some people living down here. Haven't got the map down there quite yet. So for now, let's see if we can take off. All right. Here we go. So we just looked at the map, and see up here, there's something exciting. Built this before the server launched. I don't think anyone's really figured it out yet. So we won't spoil it too much. There's a couple different things though that we built. There's the spawn zone, and here is the village. Here's the village. We'll head up. We have a little shopping district right here, which is really exciting. Looks like we've had some additions. The library roof is really coming together. We also have the glass shop, a couple different things going on. Our Christmas tree from the holidays. There it is. There's the house. Let's head out to the swamp really quick. And you can just see some of what Kitten Breath is doing out here. It really is just an incredible build, this little hut out here. It's really, really gorgeous. I am just in love with it. We're out of fireworks, so we're gonna be running back. That's fine. That's fine. We can run back. We can do that. And here you can see the beautiful sunset as it sets over Baytown. I'm really excited about this map. I'm really excited. We just started over a couple months ago. Or I guess December? December 1st was when we started on this map, so it's coming along nicely. I'm really happy with how it's turning out, and I hope you are too. I hope that you join us on this map. But for today, a couple different things that we're going to be working on. First off is we need to get some villagers back into the bar. So we'll see what we can do. First, we're going to sleep. So it's not night, which means the villagers will be hiding. We'll do it during the day. We'll see how it goes. Okay, so what are we going to need for this? We will definitely need some rails. Maybe some powered rails. And I might have some levers here. I have one lever, one redstone torch. And we'll need a minecart. So, two minecarts. Realize I probably could have done that slightly more efficiently, but that will do us. So let's head out and see if we can find some people who want to work for us. Hello, friends. Weaponsmith. Hello. I see you there. What are you? You're the butcher. I want you. Hi. Wait. Don't you want to work for me? Hey. All right. So one down. Let's see if we can push him out. Down there. Through the doors is gonna be tricky. We're gonna have to get rid of these two doors for right now. We also have some stairs to contend with. I'm not thrilled about it. Hi, are you another butcher? You're a leather worker. What about you? What are you? A fisherman. And sell some cooked fish. No! Wrong guy. Get out of here. I'm so sorry. I did not mean any offense. Oh my god. Iron golems get mad if you accidentally hit the villagers. This is the guy though, right? Fisherman. There we go. Hi, fisherman. He'll be a lot easier to get in. Let's get the fisherman first. Okay. All right. Alright, so I think that should work. Let's send our little friend down that path. There he goes. Alright, he's in the right direction. Wasn't exactly as planned. Give him a push in the right direction. And there we go. One villager in place. We have the fisherman. We can buy some cooked cod from this guy. Meanwhile, we have about a million creepers right here. By the way, I'm just gonna seal that up. Guys are coming in. So now we have to find the other villager. And connect him to this right here. Right here. So we need to somehow get him from, I believe he's over here in this building. Yeah. Over here. Oh, hello. Hi. You're my new employee. Come with. I don't understand, friend. What are you trying to do? Here and there. Okay. So, in theory, take him over this way. If we go up here, it's gonna have the least amount of stairs that we have to knock out. So we'll head him up that way and send him over. There you go. Go up there. No! No! Wrong way. Alright, we have a butcher. We have a fisherman. This has been blocked off. I think that's where some of the miniature mobs were getting through, because in here should not have any spawnable areas. And in order to get the mob farm to work, we had to light up everything. Everything's lit up. Underground, the caves are lit up, this whole area out into the forest. It is all lit up. So obviously when you come here, by the way, you have to go down the red carpet. Obviously. Obviously. Wonderful. Alright, so that's one job done. We'll have to figure out what we want to do next. Oh no. Oh no. Alright, I know what we're doing next. So I set up this retaining wall back when I first established my base. It was one of the first things I did. It was a little hill up there. But once I started building down here, we had to sort of hold the wall back from the desert, especially over here with the farms. This was a big terraforming project. You can see there's like some exposed rock in there. But then I built the road system. Road system came later. You can see it here. We got some sidewalks, nice little roads going around, sort of showing you how to get around. And you can see they overlap. They were off. So this entire wall here needs to move back one. That whole wall. This wall over here at some point got moved back. It used to be out here. There used to be a whole lot going on here. It's all different. It's all changed. But I haven't gone through and actually fixed it. It's just cobblestone right now. You can see over here, tried to make it a little mix. Have some stairs, some mossy cobblestone, things like that in here to try and liven it up just a little bit. And so what we're gonna do today is we're gonna make this over here a little bit more like this wall. So we're gonna beautify it. We're gonna make it really pretty, and we're gonna move this wall back one block. So it's gonna be a little tricky, but I think we can manage it today. Just a little bit of a progress update here for you guys. Have been able to clear out a little bit of an area here that we're gonna do the build in. You can see some of the natural landscaping here that's happened. Let me just clear out these right here because they're no longer being used. There are several blocks that we're gonna be using today to build. We are gonna be using our regular dirt, some coarse dirt, some cobblestone stairs right here, regular cobblestone blocks, as well as some moss stone, some cobblestone slabs, and some smooth stone. Not very much smooth stone because we have been making a lot of stone slabs that we're gonna be using for the sidewalk. So that's gonna be the main blocks that we're gonna be using for this build. We also need to tear out this side, so we need to save just a few to make sure that we're able to beautify that wall as well. We want to make sure that's nice and pretty, nice and pretty. So I'll check in with a little bit of a progress update in a minute once we've figured out what is going to be happening here. Alright, we have a little bit of a progress update. The sun is coming up. I've been working through the night, and there we go. It's not much. It's not bad. One of the things, it looks like there's still a little bit of stuff I need to fix here. But I did move the entire walkway back one. That way it's in line, just sort of a straight street like that. It is a little bit, like this corner that it's so straight does bug me just a little bit. Like I could lift it up. I could break it up just a little bit and like there's a little like bump over here in the sidewalk or something. Yeah, I don't know. Let me know what you think. I know straight edges are like bug some people in Minecraft. I get it. But the point of this area is that it is, it's a road with a retaining wall. I feel like that should have a pretty flat sort of line, especially if we're doing it well. Or if we're going for something that looks like it's new. So there's still a little bit for us to do. We haven't filled in the back. You notice that we did sort of build a hill here. So we're gonna build up a little bit with a little bit of dirt. A little dip, just a little one, and then it'll go up again and hold back this hill, which has a cave in it. We are getting some monster noises. It's definitely our form. Let's make sure we get our looting sword really quick. There we go. That should help with some of the noise. Here's our nice little wall. I'm really not sure how I feel about this. Maybe like that. Let me know what you think. It's just one thing, but it does break up a big line. Over here, let's take a little bit of this out. Okay. So what we're gonna do now, we've taken out some random blocks. We want one here and here. And we're just gonna replace them with some of the blocks that we brought. We have some smooth stone. Just sprinkle it in. There's one. We have some stairs. I don't think I can put the stairs there. I did want to put a stone slab here. That way it's holding that back a little bit better. And I may even want to put a dirt there. That should be fine. We still have a hole here. I think that's a great spot for some stairs. There's that. Down here would actually be a really nice spot for some stairs as well. There we go. This is looking a little too polished for me. So we're gonna just take a whack at it. Put in some stairs there. You know, what can we do here? Maybe a mossy. That's a little better. That. And we can just add one of the stone slabs. Maybe there. Yeah, we got little buckles in the sidewalk here and there. You gotta. Taking care of a city's heart. You know, taking care of a city is hard. But it looks like. So that's gonna be our walls. They look pretty good, I think. It's coming together. We'll put in some stairs. Come up this way. Still need it. Let's get this really quick. This part's gonna be a little bit trickier because we are dealing with the park. And because the park is in a desert, we have to use actual grass blocks if we want there to be grass. Oh shit. There we go. That's better. That's how you do it. Some coarse dirt. And there we go. We do want a little bit of bone meal, just one. And it looks like it's time to clear the trap anyway. Speaking of bone meal, should get a lot out of this. Hello, all. You can- oh, don't kill yourselves. There you go. Flush the system. Just grab one bone. Keep coming. Alright, so we'll just use a bone meal. Take out the red flower, because we're using specific flowers. How are we feeling about that overgrowth? Is it too much? I think it's pretty good. So there we go, the sun is setting on another day in Minecraft. We've had a lot of progress. We did catch some villagers. We set them up. We fixed the bar and grill. We managed. This was a big project. This was a heavy lift today. It was really exciting. I'm happy that we got this wall done. I'm really pleased with how it turned out. So I hope that you are too. If you've enjoyed this episode, if you've enjoyed hanging out with me on the Grishno Realm, then hit the like button. If you like this video, subscribe. We'll see if we can get some more like this on the channel. I've had a ton of fun making it, so until then, until the next time I see you, I've been Grishno, and I will see you later.